with Stella and Chewie's here, and she's going to go ahead and answer some of her questions about their new kibbles and raw blend that we've gone ahead and brought in. So first off, Mary, thanks for coming.
Thank you for having me.
Doing this event. We really appreciate it.
Absolutely.
And we've just brought in some of your kibbles, so I kind of wanted to go over because I know the we've got some weird proteins, and I'm a big fan of it. So we actually brought in the duck raw coated kibble and the lamb, and then we also have the raw blend free range and red meat. Now, can you tell me the difference between what the raw coated kibble and the blend is?
Absolutely. So we have actually done a really great job of making sure that our kibble is super palatable. The kibble is baked, it's coated in the appropriate animal fat, it is then rolled and freeze-dried. So we have found that to be a very effective way of getting your picky, finicky, or bored dogs to eat.
Which might be why Mr. Hare's dogs will no longer touch other kibble other than the Stella and Chewie's. We messed up and we let them try a couple of sample bags, and they will now look blankly at a bowl of pretty much anything else and look back at you and kind of be like, where's the good stuff?
Right. Well, I'm happy about that. So the difference really between the raw coated kibble and the raw blend kibble, I wouldn't call it a difference per se. The raw coated kibble and the raw blend kibble are the same. The difference between the two is that the raw blend actually adds a bag of meal mixers in with the kibble. So you have the benefit of freeze-dried, kind of double freeze-dried. You get the benefit of the meal mixers, you also get the benefit of the kibble being coated in the raw as well.
Okay. But theoretically, you could just get a bag of kibble and a bag of meal mixers.
Absolutely.
And make raw blend.
Sure. Okay. Sure. Yep. The other part, speaking to lamb, our new free-range recipe is actually kind of some unique proteins. It's goat, lamb, and elk. So if you had customers who really did prefer a raw blend, they didn't really want to mix in the meal mixers, they do have the option of using the free range versus buying the bag of raw coated and mixing the meal mixers in. I'm always happy for people to mix those meal mixers in, don't get me wrong, but there are some other options.
Awesome. So with the red meat recipe, I know we went ahead and brought in the small breed,
mm-hmm.
but y'all also do kind of a regular size traditional kibble as
we
well.
Do,
correct?
We do. We have. Mm-hmm.
And so, what's the difference between the small breed and the more regular red meat blend?
So, the small breed, you know, everybody will say, oh, well, what's the difference between the small breed and the regular beef kibble? So, small breed, the formulations are a little bit different. Small breed dogs tend to live longer, they tend to bounce around like ping pong balls a little bit longer. So, you're going to find some benefits of some additional added glucosamine and chondroitin. Calcium phosphorus levels are a little bit different, and the protein and fat levels are a little bit different. They're specifically catered to those smaller breed dogs.
Okay.
The kibble is also slightly smaller because we want to make sure those teeny tiny guys can eat it.
Okay, very cool. And then I did want to go ahead and talk to you. I know I've got a lot of people who ask me what the difference between the meal mixers and the patties are. And I've always just said the shape.
You are indeed correct.
Okay.
Yes. there is, it's just, some folks think it's a little bit more simple to just be able to scoop and go versus, you know, breaking patties or kind of the look of the patties in the bowl. So they are literally the same product, just in a different form.
Okay.
So.
Cool. And then, yeah, with the meal mixers, I know it's got the little scoop
in there. Yes.
So if you've got, you know, like a weird sized dog that doesn't hit an exact patty amount, you can kind of just scoop and it's a little bit easier that way. If you've got a real picky dog that you gotta smush everything up and mix it.
Right.
So everything is coated, you might just be fine to do the patty.
Absolutely.
Add a little bit of water.
Sure. I'm a fan of patty crumbling. You know, sometimes that's you can crumble the patties to the point where you can literally touch every piece of kibble in the bowl if you're feeding kibble. So.
Yeah, that's kind of what we
sure.
have to do because Artemis will strategically pick out
yes.
every individual chunk that she can. So I found I have to reconstitute it with a little bit of water and kind of make it gravy.
Sure.
And that way, not only does she get all of the patty, but she'll actually eat all of the kibble.
Right.
Which now saves me from having to switch every 15-pound bag. We can get a 30-pound bag of kibble and switch flavors every 30 pounds.
Variety is the spice of life.